details on the story that again Republic very closely tracked. You would recall that entire CCTV footage of that VVIP convict called Sasikala that was caught and questioned then by many. And we can now tell you that the retired IAS officer Vinay Kumar has submitted his report to the state government. Sources are confirming now to Republic that the allegations made by D. Roopa of the jail authorities receiving bribe for giving privileges has been confirmed in that report. So that is a big development in the entire case, because remember, D. Roopa did come out and talk about all those allegations. And importantly, remember, she stands vindicated today. D. Roopa also joins us on the phone line here on Republic. D. Roopa, thank you for speaking to us here. So finally, there is this probe report, D. Roopa, that is exactly reiterating what you said, that yes, bribe was given, the reason why Sasikala was given that special treatment.
Yes, I had pointed out the irregularities, the differential treatment, given as quid pro quo. Otherwise, there's no need to give those kind of special facilities to someone there, just because one is influential. So it is quid pro quo in exchange for money. And I'm not aware of the report as yet. I only know that it has been submitted. And yes, people have been telling me that it is in line with what I found, in line with my findings. And if that is so, it's well and good. And I'm very happy about it. And hello.
Yes, we can hear you, ma'am.
Yeah, and action should be taken on the culprits who are responsible for these irregularities, and that will be a stepping stone to prison reform as well.
And, you know, that's a fantastic point that you do make, Ms. Roopa, but I really want to understand this. Why did the government never believed you? Why those who should have actually taken action on the basis of what you actually told them then never acted, and they instead were hitting out at you?
There's nothing much I can comment on this. But when I submitted the report to my senior, that is my boss himself, he should have said that I will look into this. But instead, he rubbished it. And that was the reason why another probe was done, a committee was set up, and good that the findings are out. And already there has been a bit of delay, about three and a half months. I'm sure actions will be taken now, at least. And government transferred me and I joined the new post. So there's nothing much more I can comment on this. Hello?
But why did they not believe you? You know, Ms. Roopa, that's a question everyone today is asking. Why were you not believed? Why were you targeted?
I really haven't bothered on those questions. And I don't feel targeted by anyone, because I look at it very professionally. That was my duty, to expose things or rectify it, which was happening there, and I did that. And you can only do whatever is in your jurisdiction or is in your hands, and that's what I've done. And beyond that, the system is there, we'll take care of it. I look at it professionally that way.
And in hindsight, Roopa, do you believe that had the state government stood by you, actually acted on this entire report that you submitted not once but twice with a good enough of proof, things could have been different? Because look at what the message was sent out. Look at the entire kind of messaging that was given, that this is a state administration not even standing with an honest officer.
No, I have nothing to say on this. Now that the committee has given report, I'm sure action will follow. And yeah, that's it. And actually, I have not been harassed that way by anyone. I don't look at transfers as harassment, and they are part of government job. And I don't feel harassment even if somebody wants to harass. So it's all in mind, one's mind. So I don't take it that way. Yeah, that's all I have to say. Yes.
Okay, and before I let you go, Roopa, is there one message that you want to give out to the society, to people who are watching you? Because everyone stood by you. Everyone, actually lauded you for the kind of report you submitted, for the kind of, openness that you came out with on a VVIP convict like a Sasikala, and the state was not even willing to believe you. What is that one thing you want to tell everyone today, also your naysayers?
There was huge support across the party. I must say this, across the party lines, there was huge support. So that itself shows that, you know, a common man wants things to be set right. They want to see bureaucrats acting in a manner accountable and transparent and setting things right. And when that is done, people appreciate, the society actually appreciates, and that itself is a big reinforcement for bureaucrats to do whatever they can as per in the legal framework, and set things right.